Hi, I'm Jim Zwack from the Davy Institute, North America's premier tree research laboratory, and today we're talking trees. If you have an ash tree, you know the unique character and beauty it brings to your yard. Unfortunately, here in North America over the past two decades, these trees have also become the target of the emerald ash borer, or EAB. EAB has destroyed hundreds of millions of trees, but fortunately, over time, we've learned much more about how to effectively treat and save the ash trees on your property. To talk more about EAB and treatment options, I'm joined by one of our local experts, ISA certified arborist Jesse Tabb. So Jesse, what do we need to know?
Thanks, Jim. This pest targets both healthy and unhealthy trees, so it's important to act fast if you live in an impacted area. So where should you start? First, you'll want to determine if you have an ash tree on your property. Ash trees have branches and leaves with 7 to 9 eye-shaped leaflets that grow opposite each other. They also have distinctive bark with diamond-shaped patterns. Next, if you're in an area affected by EAB, you'll want to have your ash tree inspected by a certified arborist. If it's deemed a good candidate for preservation, you can begin treatment to prevent infestation. Soil and trunk injections are used most often as they deliver treatment right to the tree's tissue and help limit environmental exposure. Bark and canopy sprays are also available. One question we commonly hear is how effective is treatment? If applied at the right time and in the right way by a certified applicator, EAB treatment is 90 to 95% effective and can save the trees in your yard. Preventative treatment is always best for your tree. If there are infested trees within a few miles, you should consider beginning treatments right away. Even if you spot some of the early symptoms of EAB, like mild canopy thinning or woodpeckers foraging in the upper canopy, there's likely still time for early treatment. If your trees are left untreated, you may eventually notice other symptoms like dead and broken branches or abnormal branches sprouting from the trunk or the base of the tree, D-shaped exit holes in the bark, and S-shaped tunnels beneath the bark. If your ash tree is already infested beyond saving or poses a risk to surrounding trees, you will need to safely remove and dispose of the wood to prevent the spread of EAB. You'll want to check local guidelines for proper disposal methods, such as chipping or burning. Proactively monitoring and managing EAB can drastically improve your tree's chances for survival, leaving you to enjoy its beauty and benefits for years to come.
Thanks, Jesse. Some helpful tips for protecting our ash trees for future generations. For more information about EAB prevention and management, contact your local professional arborist. As always, thanks for talking trees.